MyPillow CEO Mike Lindell is an expert. Unfortunately, he's an expert on pillows. That's not what he's being brought on Newsmax to talk about. And they quickly discover that, hey, wait, maybe he's actually crazy.
So well, what happened? What happened with your Twitter account and the company page?
Well, first mine was taken down because we have all the election fraud with these Dominion machines. We have 100% proof. And then when they took it down about 3 weeks ago, when I put it back up, my personal,
you're talking about machines that we at Newsmax have not been able to verify any of those kinds of allegations. We just want to let people know that there's nothing substantive that we've seen. And let me read you something there. While there were some clear evidence of some cases of vote fraud and election irregularities, the election results in every state were certified, and Newsmax accepts the results as legal and final. The courts have also supported that view. So right, we wanted to talk to you about canceling culture, if you will. We don't want to relitigate the allegations that you're making, Mike, because we understand where you are. So let me ask you this. Do you think that this should be temporary? Because it appears to be permanent. Could you make an argument that it is temporary?
What?
Could you make an argument that this could be a temporary banning rather than permanent?
No, I want it to be a permanent because you know what? They did this because I'm revealing all the evidence on Friday of all the election fraud with these machines. So I'm sorry if you think it's not
Mike,
it's real.
Can I ask our producers, can we get out of here, please? I don't want to have to keep going over this.
Actually,
we at Newsmax have not been able to verify any of those allegations.
Mike, hold on 1 second. Let's talk a little bit about just what is happening overall in terms of censorship of
cancel out my company and myself.
Biden is now president, which if you were watching Newsmax, first of all, why? Second of all, they told you he wouldn't be. And so now they need to come to grips with this. And so we've got a bunch of videos of them admitting that they got it wrong. No, we don't. But we do have videos of them responding to the inauguration. So here's a Newsmax host. I have no idea who this is, and I'm not particularly interested in finding out, but he is on Newsmax. So here he is. Take a look at what issue he had with the inauguration.
Like a homily, a priest. Joe Biden may be Catholic, but he supports abortion and he can't pronounce Psalms. A priest is the last person I would compare him to. I don't think a priest would invite the Trump-hating Lady Gaga to sing either. For a man who is calling for unity, Biden calls on her to sing the national anthem. So it's not who we wanted to hear from. There is nothing in the national anthem that Joe Biden seems to value. Yet the media love fest continued.
I did not watch Saturday Night Live. I watched the clips. The show's on too late. Quite frankly, I don't think it's that funny anymore. What'd you think of Elon Musk's performance? This is the first time since 2015 we've had a non-athlete, non-entertainer on the show. The last person to do that and do well with great ratings. Our former president, Donald Trump.
Well, Rob, it's a great question. I mean, what happened on SNL this weekend was that people made stuff up and then said it on television like it's true. And that actually happens pretty frequently in American TV. For example, in 2020, Dominion Voting System sued Newsmax over its false claims about election fraud. Newsmax was lying to its own viewers, and Newsmax had to settle that lawsuit. So actually, I just need to check in. Are you still telling that lie, or are you telling new lies?
Wait, are we talking about, I'm sorry, David, are we talking about, do you want to talk about something completely non-related and try to catch me on a Monday morning totally off topic, or do you want to talk about Elon Musk?
Well, I can see why you don't want to talk about Dominion voting systems, because if you do, Newsmax could get sued and lose billions of dollars.
So if you'd like to talk about Saturday Night Live, I will do that with you. But obviously, I'm not going to talk about anything else right now. So you decide right now in this moment on live television. Go ahead.
Did Dominion voting systems have any impact on the 2020 election?
Oh, that's unfortunate, because I was really excited about this interview. I didn't watch SNL on Saturday night, but I thought Elon Musk did an okay job. And he also said that he's got Asperger's. So I thought that was a fascinating component of the monologue. So, David, we look forward to having him back on very soon again. That was a stellar interview. David Litt, thanks so much for joining us. We'll be right back.
Thanks so much. I don't understand what that what that interview is supposed to be. He said he was super excited to do it, but not excited enough to watch the episode of a show that he says Elon Musk did well in, even though he says he didn't watch it. Like, for instance, I didn't watch SNL. I did skim through it, and every time I saw Elon Musk, I advanced forward. And thus, I can't say that Elon Musk didn't do a good job or did do a good job, but he's found a way around that. He doesn't even need to watch it to know.
What was the angle anyway? Do you know what I mean? Like, what did he want this former Obama person to say about Elon Musk? I thought he was really good. Lies, you are a Democratic shill. You would say that because you love the billionaire. Like, no, I didn't like him. It's because you hate Mars. It's because you and your Democrat, you know, it's hard to know how he was even going to play this on a Monday morning, you know, but like, yes. Oh God, Newsmax, you non-storied, but I love that this guy just decided to turn it on its head. That's what more people should be doing when they go on shows, is to actually just roast the hosts. And that's what I will do from now on, John.